Okay. Do you remember this section? What was about? It is about the continuity. So what we have here, we have, Shabab, mainly six concepts, six ideas, mainly six ideas. This slide, Shabab, is important. Don't think that the first slide is not important. It is one of the most important slides in any section. Why? Because it will shows you the objectives of this section, also the main contents of this section, also what are the questions that could come from this section. For example, here they may ask you about the continuity at a number. They may ask you about removable, infinite, and jump discontinuities. They may ask you about left and right continuity and continuity over an interval, about the properties of the continuous function, the addition, subtraction, composition, and so on, and about the intermediate value theorem. So you may have six questions from this section. Okay? So it is important to have to look at what you have in the section at the beginning before going to the section. So if you remember, we have defined the continuous function to be the function that its limit when x approaching a is the same as the value of the function at a. So this means, in fact, you need to check three conditions: that the value of the function at a defined, the limit when x approaches a is exists, and they are equals to each other. So if these three conditions satisfy, then the function is continuous at the number a or at the point a and f of a. And we have, of course, explained these examples. I will not repeat them. According to what we had in the previous class, according to these examples, we have classified the discontinuities to be removable or infinite or jump. You can see clearly, Shabab, when we have removable, we can redefine the function to remove them. So removable, when you have a hole, this is a removable. Infinite, when the function goes to infinity or negative infinity. So look here, this function at zero, it will go to positive infinity. So this is what we call it infinite, when the limit goes to infinity. In other words, when we have vertical asymptote, if x equals zero is a vertical asymptote, then we have what is called infinite discontinuity. It will happen at the vertical asymptote. And the other type is the jump. When the limit from the right different from the limit of the left, you have a jump. Is that clear? So let's see now, Shabab. I will give you 1 minute, 1 minute to solve this, please. This function has, I will give you the choices also. Let me launch a polling. Can you see it now, Shabab?
Yes, we can.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. How can you know immediately like that? MashaAllah, this is a guessing or solution. Are you a magician or a mathematician? Mathematicians, mashallah, they cannot do it like this. 1 second. But magicians, maybe if you have a magic tricks. Students. Excellent, ya shabab. By the way, I have these reports, ya shabab, of the pollings. So I can check later who choose A and who choose B. I can know exactly which one choose which answer.
Doctor,
it is not just for fun. I will consider it in the future, inshallah.
Doctor.
Yes.
The ball didn't appear to me.
في عندك حاجة اسمها balls. Click on it. في ثلاثة أعمدة مكتوب جنبها pool. Three columns like this. Pools. If it is not showing for you, I can share it with you if you want.
I didn't find it.
Are you with us in the WhatsApp group?
Yes.
Okay, Shabab. Anyone of you, Shabab, just take a photo, please, and show your colleague where he can find it. واحد ياخذ صوره يا شباب ويرسلها على الواتساب جروب عشان زميلكم شيك عليها لانه I want him to see exactly what you have. I can send him my screenshot but it will not it will look different from his screen.
دكتور when you launch the poll it automatically appears to us. We don't have to go anywhere.
And once you submit it it disappears.
Yes. So he don't go anywhere. The poll should appear to him.
He can, but also he can hide it. He can minimize the screen of the polls. He can hide it and show it. But when you submit, after you submit, yes, you cannot see it.
But I didn't submit anything.
Let's check that in the WhatsApp group. We cannot help you right now during the class about that. So let's end the polling now, Shabab. And let me share with you the results. Can you see the results now? 15 students with A, 5 with B, 6 with C, 8 with D, and 2 with E. MashaAllah, يعني وزعته بعدالة يعني على كل الاختيارات. Why you didn't agree about an answer? We did this, by the way, in the previous class, the removable and the discontinuities. But it's okay, let me stop sharing. And let's see together what is the answer. The answer is, the right answer is A. Why it is A? Let's see, Shabab, and you need to focus, please, with me. There are many old exam questions about the same idea. So what you should do first, you should just write your function. Now, you need to factor it to simplify the expression. So you can x squared, it is x minus 1, x plus 1. This is the same, you will do the same, Shabab. If you want to study or to find the type of the discontinuities, you need to do as you did in math 001 when you find the vertical asymptotes. Now, can I cancel this with this? But I should say that this equals to x over x plus 1, provided that x is not equals to 1. If x is not 1, I can cancel. So what we have at 1, what we did, we removed this factor, this term. So a factor can be x minus 1, we remove it. We cancel it. In this case, we have a whole. So we will have a whole at 1 because we removed that one. It is the same as here, Shabab. If you remember this case or this case, when we factor, we cancel x minus 2 with x minus 2. And because of that, we had a whole at that point. So now, what we can now guarantee until now at x equals 1, we have a removable discontinuity. Okay, so we have one removable. Now what will happen when the denominator is 0? You need to find the limit. You know the limit of x goes to 1 from the right and the limit of x goes to the left of the function, and you will see what will happen in both cases. Sometimes if it is only defined from the right or from the left, you can do it just from both sides at the same time. Anyway, in this case it will be positive infinity and negative infinity. For example, you can see here to negative 1, not to 1, to negative 1, because this will be negative 1. So here, of course, yes, Shabab, x equals negative 1 is a vertical asymptote. Am I right?
Yes.
So at x equals to negative 1, we have an infinity discontinuity. So it will be an infinite discontinuity. So what about, do we have other points that we have discontinuity at? No. Only we have one removable and one infinite. How to make sure that it is infinite? Of course, it is vertical asymptote. When you have vertical asymptote, it will go to infinity or negative infinity when you are approaching that number. But you can calculate it. It is not difficult. When x goes to negative 1 from the right, what will happen? It will be negative 1 from the right over negative 1 from the right plus 1. So this will be equals to what? Let me write it here. X equals negative 1 is... Or other way here, x equals negative 1 is a vertical asymptote. Now it will be what? Negative 1 over negative zero plus, am I right? Because it will be negative one from the right, so it will be smaller. Smaller than negative one. So it will be like negative 0.9. When you add it to one, it will be positive. So it will be zero plus, it will be negative infinity. And of course, when x goes to negative one from the left, it will be negative one from the left, which will be one over negative one from the left plus one, negative one from the left. Oh, this is wrong, by the way. Negative one from the left, this is zero, this is one, this is negative one. Negative one from the left, it means it is negative 0.9. So this case is not true. From the right and from the left. From the right, it will be negative 0.9. So this will be, in fact, zero minus. Am I right? It will be negative 0.9. Let me check. No, it's okay. From the right, it is negative 0.9 plus one, so it will be positive. And that one is correct. Now, from the left, it means that it will go to negative one point something, like negative 1.1. So this will be negative minus, it will be zero minus, and this negative one, of course, zero minus, and it will be negative over negative, it will be positive infinity. So this is just in case you are, you may think that it will be jump. When we have different limits from the right and from the limit, from the right and from the left, but they are not vertical asymptote. This is a vertical asymptote, so no need to check that because it is clearly vertical asymptote. In some situations, you may have different from the right and different from the left, but not infinity and negative infinity. In that case, it will be jump. But if it is two different numbers from the right and from the left, it will be jump. But when it is infinity or negative infinity, so it doesn't matter, is it infinity or negative infinity, you have a vertical asymptote there and the discontinuity will be infinite. Discontinuity.
Victor?
Yes.
At x equals to 1, we have another vertical asymptote?
No, we don't. We have a hole. Here, we have a hole at x equals 1. We have a hole. When we have removable discontinuity, we have a hole, Shabab. Yeah, Shabab, where were you? Here, when we have removable, it is a hole. When it is infinite, we have vertical asymptote. Is this clear? When it is jump, we have two different limits from the right and from the left. They are not infinity or negative infinity. Two numbers, two real numbers, different from each other. Is that clear? Yes. Shabab?
Yes. Is that clear? Yes,
clear. Practice, Shabab, practice similar problems in the old exams. There are many. Okay, let's continue. We have also mentioned in the previous class the continuity from the right and continuity from the left. It is the same as the limit, just when it is from the right, you call it continuous from the right. If it is from the left, you call it from the left. Also, over an interval. When you have continuity over an interval, you need to check every point in that interval. To make it easier for you, I have added this box here. The function is continuous over closed interval A and B. If it is continuous at each point in the open interval, so this is the closed interval. You have this closed interval A and B. You need it to be continuous over each point here, and also you need to make sure to close it here. So you need to check B from the right, from the left. This is B, this is the left of B. So you need to check the limit from the left of the B, and of course, from the right of the left endpoint from A, to make sure that it is continuous, there is no any problem until the end. Now, we had an example about that also. Also, the properties of the continuous function. If you have two continuous functions at a number, then the sum, the difference, the product, and the quotient of them also will be continuous at that number. Good news that any polynomial is continuous everywhere. Also, the rational functions are continuous over their domains. Any function, Shabab, any function will be continuous. It's doing. To study the continuity, by the way, to study the continuity, you need just to find the domain. Keep this in mind. I have added this and update, ya Shabab, your slides. I usually update the slides in the Blackboard. So try to make sure that you get the recent, the last updated version of the slides. To study the continuity of a function, you need to find the domain. Well, as hell. So when they ask you where it is continuous, where it is not, Just find the domain and you will know where it is continuous, where it is not. For example, to find this limit, just if you know the domain, is there any problem at negative 2? No problem. Because what is the domain of this function? The domain is, of this function is all the real numbers except 5 over 3. So there is no problem at any real number except 5 over 3. Okay? So because of that, you can make a direct substitution. So when the function is continuous and you want to find the limit, so easy, just direct substitution. This is one of the most important theorem because it is about everything. It says that the following functions, polynomials, rational, root, trigonometric, inverse, trigonometric, exponential, logarithmic, all of them are continuous at every number in their what? In their domains. And this confirms again, to study continuity of any function, first find its domain. And we had this in the previous class, if I'm right. So if you want, where is this function continuous? What you need to do? It is the same answer for this question. If someone asks you this question, what is the domain of this function? These two questions are the same. So all what you need to do, Yashara, is to find the domain. So now you need to ask yourself, ln x, it is a continuous function over its domain, which is from 0 to infinity. Tan inverse, it is continuous everywhere because its domain is all the real numbers. So now the sum of them will be continuous by theorem number 4 because the addition of two continuous functions is continuous. Now, this polynomial in the denominator, it is polynomial, so it is continuous everywhere, but unfortunately, it is in the denominator. So because it is in the denominator, we should consider the case that it is zero, when it is zero. So we should exclude one and the negative one. So now we had what? We have from zero to infinity, and we have from negative infinity to infinity, and we have all the real numbers except negative one and positive one. So what will be the domain, Shabab? The domain will be all the real numbers except all the positive real numbers except one. So, because if you consider it is just a matter of finding this is zero and it is open. This is one, open. This is negative one, open. And it is from zero to infinity, here it is. Now you will take from negative one, all the real numbers, you will take the intersection except one. So it is from zero to infinity, remove one. Let's take another example. I think we have stopped here in the previous class. Yes.
We start from zero because of ln, right? Or
we said that here, it is mentioned here. So it is just a matter of finding the domain of this function. How to find the domain of this function? To find the domain of this function, what you will do? You will say the domain is x such that here x is greater than zero. Here x is any real number, so don't mention anything. Here it is. And x cannot equal positive or negative one. Just like that, this is the domain. And you write it as an interval from zero to one, union from one to infinity. Just like that. This is the domain and the function will be continuous there according to theorem number 9 that says that every function will be continuous over its domain. Now this function also, it is about the limits also. Why we are talking about the limits here? Because if the function is continuous near, if it is continuous near this number, then it will be direct substitution. So what you can do, here, you can check if you can make a direct substitution or not. Let's do the direct substitution, Shabab. It will be sine by is what? Over two plus cosine by. So it will be equals to what? Zero, sine by zero, two plus, what is cosine by? Negative one.
Minus one.
So it will be zero over one, which will be zero over one is zero. So the limit by the direct substitution, okay. If you want to make sure that you are allowed here to use the direct substitution, you can ask yourself, sine x, is it continuous? Sine yes. x is continuous. And also, cosine x is continuous. 2 plus x is continuous. But this one is in the denominator. You have to be careful. It might be 0. Is this possible to have to be 0? Cosine x can be negative 2?
No.
So there is no x will make the denominator zero. So it is always greater than zero. So it is never zero because it is always greater than zero. Why it is greater than zero? Because you know, Shabab, that cosine x is always greater than negative one, less than or equals one. So if you add two for both cases of the sides, this is what you are going to have. So it is greater than one. So this is why it is always positive. Of that, it cannot be negative. It cannot be negative, and it cannot be zero. Of course, this expression. So no problem. So it will be continuous everywhere. So this function is continuous everywhere. Because of that, you can use the direct substitution. Now, if f is continuous and at a number b, and the limit of another function g at x goes to b, it is also b. Then the limit of the composition of them will be f of b. In other words, ya shabab, and you have a, if you have a composition of two functions and you need to find the limit when x goes to a, you can write it as f of the limit of the function g when x goes to a, like that. Just you need to check or to make sure that f is continuous at f is continuous at g of a. When you put instead of, or the limit, let's say, continuous at p, which is the limit of the function when x goes to a. Just of course, if you what you can do, you can find the limit, evaluate the function. If it is defined, you can continue. If it is not, stop. Let's take an example about that. So it says that you can put the limit inside. Let's take an example, the limit of, what is this?
Sine inverse.
What is sine this inverse. This is sine inverse, arc sine is sine inverse. And this is just, you remember, because we take an arc from the sine, so we call it arc sine. And be careful, Shabab, here, this is not the reciprocal, Math 002. It is not the reciprocal, this is something different. Okay, now, so you need to ask yourself now, by the direct substitution, if you make a direct substitution, you will have what? Zero, zero. Now, if you put inside the limit, how can you do this? So what you need to do is to make sure about your function. Do you remember sine, arc sine? Is it continuous? What is the domain of this function? What is the domain of this function? Do you remember?
-1 to 1.
One.
From negative 1 to 1, yeah, Shabab. It's okay, Shabab. You can revise 002 into, yeah, Shabab, ما درستم 001 و 002 للتسلية. انتو درستوهم عشان تحتاجوهم في المادة هاي. فما يمنع ان النوتات تبعك حقت 001 و 002 ترجع لها وقت ما تحتاج. When you need to check something, you can go back and see it again. It will be easier for you to memorize it because they are your notes. So what you can here, remember that this function is continuous, but we need, of course, to check first the limit, what will be the limit, and we will check the continuity after that. Now, what you will do, you can take the limit inside, both the limit inside. And this means, in fact, you can make a direct substitution. But the problem that you will have 1 minus 1 over 1 minus 1, it will be 0 over 0, and this is undetermined case. What we can do, ya Shabab, here for this limit to find this limit, we have studied that in 2.3. What you can do? You can multiply by the conjugate. You can multiply by 1 plus x over 1 plus x. This is not bad idea, a good idea. But there is another idea here. Do you remember a squared minus b squared?
You can take a common factor from the denominator.
Do you remember that? What about if it is a and b only? It will be here square root, square root. Square root, square root. You can write it also this way. So it is still difference of squares. So what we will do now, we will replace 1 minus x. We will write it as, this is a trick that you can learn if you didn't use before. Okay? Now, this is 1 minus x. Now you can cancel this with this because, of course, x is not exactly 1. Now you'll have arc sine of the limit of 1, which is what? 1 over what it will be? 1 over square root of a half. Now, is this a half in the domain? What is the domain we said before? -1 and 1. Is this in the domain?
Yes.
Yes.
Of course, you can evaluate it. Who can remind me what is the sine inverse of a half? What is arc sine a half?
Root 2.
Sine.
What? Who said root 2? Root 2 what?
30.
Be careful, we are talking about the inverse.
30. Pi over 6.
What? Pi over 6, yes, Shabab, there is no more degrees. Forget degrees. Forget them. Yeah, Shabab, this is inverse. The answer should be angle. I'm wondering about this. I'm afraid about the students who say the number. Square root of 3 over 2 or square root of 2 over 2. What is that? This is inverse function. It should be, the answer should be angle, of course, at the end. So it is pi over 6, radians, yeah, Shabab. Now, if G is continuous at A, and F is continuous at G of A, then the composite function of them is also continuous at A. It is, of course, another type of properties that you can use an example about it here. This is a composition of two functions. What are the functions? G of X is X squared, and F of X is sine X. Now, if you put this here, you would have F of G of X. So this is X, you will put X squared. So this is F of X. Now, X squared is defined everywhere. Sorry about that, yes. في تكتل في الصوت أحياناً والسبب حرارة الجهاز طبعاً لأنه أنا شغال من الصباح على الجهاز يعني كلاس ورا كلاس فلما أستخدم التاتش سكرين لما أكتب على الشاشة بشكل كثير يصير بترتفع درجة حرارة الجهاز بتقل الكفاءة ويبدأ مشاكل في الصوت but it's okay I will change the channels between that so please when you hear problems in the sound just let me know and I will change the setting So they will take a rest, the microphones and headphones and so on. So I will change the input or the port of the sound. Okay, now, so we have a composition of two functions. The question is where these functions are continuous. So is there any problem with X squared, Shabab? No, sine is defined everywhere. So remember also this, to study the continuity, you need to think about the domain. So this function, Shabab, you can write it as a composition of two functions, f and g, where g is x squared and f is sine x. Now, this function is continuous everywhere. Everywhere, it means it is continuous on the whole real numbers. And similarly, sine is continuous also on the whole real numbers. Now, since both of them are continuous, the composition of them, it is not the intersection. The composition is you have to consider this function. Where it is continuous, everywhere. So because of that, it will be continuous. We have no problem at any point. So it will be continuous wherever it is defined. Let's take the next one. F of x equals to 1 plus cosine x. Also, this is a composition of two functions. It is a composition of f and g. This is g, and ln x is f. Now, ln x is defined where? Ln x is defined over the positive numbers only from 0 to infinity. For this one, it is defined everywhere because cosine is continuous everywhere. And when you add 1, it will be continuous over the whole real numbers. It is the same as the cosine, but shifted up. Now, the question is about the composition. One of the mistakes that I may make, or you may make also, you will think that the domain of the composition is the intersection. So you will say, this is from 0 to infinity, this is the whole real number. So now the composition of them, which is ln 1 plus cosine x, it will be continuous on what? It will be continuous on what? From 0 to infinity. Is that true?
No.
It is not true. So it is not about the intersection, Shabab. When you find the domain of the sum, the difference, the product, the quotient, yes, it is about the intersection of the functions, of the domains of the function. But when we are talking about the composition of two functions, it is about the composition itself, the function itself. Ask yourself, so this is wrong what we did here. So what you need to do here, you need to look at ln 1 plus cosine and ask yourself, this is a logarithmic function. For this function to be continuous, you should have what is inside the argument inside the logarithmic function must be what? Must be positive. It should be greater than 0. So this means that cosine x greater than negative 1. Where we have this property, cosine x greater than 1? What is the solution of this inequality? You remember that cosine x is always greater than or equals negative 1, less than or equals 1. So it is always greater than negative 1. So this means that x here is any real number. But there are some numbers that they will not be greater than negative 1. What they are? So this means that x is any real number, but cosine x, we don't want it to be equals because it could be equal. So we don't want it to be negative 1. So we don't want x to be what?
Pi.
Pi.
Pi. What about 2 pi? Is it okay?
It's okay.
Yes.
No, it is not okay. What is cosine 2 pi, Shabab? Cosine 2
zero.
Pi is cosine
zero.
Zero.
It
is 1. Be careful. So it is not. So it is not 2 pi. It is 3 pi. And then 5 pi. And so on. So it is about the odd multiples. Also the negative. You can take it in positive or negative. Negative pi, negative, and so on. So now the continuity here, it is over all the real numbers except these numbers. The function is not continuous over these numbers. So again, Shabab, it is about the domain. If you want to find where the function is continuous, just you need to find the domain. So it is not continuous at these numbers, and it is continuous everywhere else. Now, do we have time? 1 minute, Shabab, 1 minute. What is the answer of this question? Let me launch this point for you. Unfortunately, we don't have time. So let me just mention the idea. How to solve, what is the idea? How to solve this question?
Find the domain.
Who said find the domain?
Me.
Abdullah Andraj?
Yes.
Ahsan, Abdullah. Ahsan, this is the answer. Yes, find the domain. So the question is, find the domain. What is the domain of this function, Shabab? The domain of this function is all the real numbers. What's that? 9 minus x squared over x plus 1 greater than 0 because it is a logarithmic function. Now, you remember this is inequality. How to solve this inequality? 3 minus x times 3 plus x over x plus 1 greater than 0. This is math 001. How to solve this inequality? You will make a table of values, negative 3, negative 1, 3, and all of them are open. Now study the signs, make a table of signs, positive, negative, negative, positive, negative, 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 positive, negative, and you solve it, you will find that this is the answer. So to study continuity of a function in general, first find its domain. Very easy. So the question is like, just find the domain. The last part of this section in Shabab is about the intermediate value theorem. And this is not new, by the way. Yes.
I have a question. Go back.
Yes, please. Don't have time, please, quickly.
Okay. You said the ln is more than zero. Why we put in the interval from minus infinity?
I don't get your point. Do you know how to solve this inequality? Do you
yes, want yes, to, I know,
do you know how to solve this inequality?
Yes, yes.
Solve it, and you will know why. Because okay. It comes from here. It will be here positive, and here it's positive. It will be here positive. Here it will be negative at the end. So you will take it when it is positive, from negative infinity to negative 3. You got it?
Yes, yes, yes.
We want the whole expression to be positive, not x. We are not talking about x only. Okay, the intermediate value theorem, Shabab. If you remember chapter 3 in math 001, you have studied this theorem there. You studied this theorem there for polynomials. Now you will study it for continuous functions. For any function that is continuous, not only for polynomials. So if you have a function that is continuous over a closed interval, and you have a number between the value of the function at the end points. Let's call this number n. Then, of course, the value of the function at the end points are different. Then there exists a number between them such that the value of the function c. In other words, if you have a point A and a point B, the value of the function at B, it is different from the value of the function at A. Look, here they are. Then in between, there is a number that is an image for another number between A and B. It could be one, it could be more than one. So what is the benefit of this theorem? In fact, the main benefit of this theorem is to estimate the roots or the zeros of equations. You have this equation, you want to solve it. You are not able to solve it. You don't know what are the solution of this. By the way, you can also solve this one by the techniques of chapter 3 of math 001. Now, you need just to know it approximately. So you need to show here that it is between 1 and 2. So to show that it is between 1 and 2, what you will do, you will put this side equals to f. You will call it f of x. Now, what you will do, you will find, this function is continuous because it is polynomial. What you will do, you will find the value of the function at A, the value of the function at B. So here they are. Now, you know when you want, Ya Shabab, what you want. If you want to show that there is a zero, a root, it means a zero. So it means that there is an x-intercept. Let me write it here. It means that you have x-intercept here. So to have x-intercept between two numbers, A and B, the value of the function at this must be positive and this must be negative, or the opposite. So you may have it like this. So in that case, if the value of the function at A is positive and another one is negative, we have what is called a root or an x-intercept. I make it here as a note for you. If you have f of A and f of B are of opposite signs, which means that one of them is positive, one of them is negative, then the continuous function f has at least one root, one x-intercept, one real zero between A and B. Now here, what is important for us first, that they should be different. Not only that, I want them to be different for the intermediate value theorem, but also I want one of them to be positive, one of them to be negative, which means that one of them is above the x-axis, one of them is below the x-axis. To connect them, because the function is continuous, to connect them, I have to cross the x-axis. So I will have at least one. I can cross it several times, no problem. But at least there will be a root between them according to the intermediate value theorem. What is that x-intercept? I'm not interested in that now. Just I'm sure that there is a number between one and two. And this satisfies the theorem and the conclusion. Hey, Shabab, please practice these exercises. It is impossible to solve all of these during the class of recitation, so practice by solving all of them at home. Also these problems. Now, do we have? No, we don't. This is an old exam question. Just let's make, Hey, Shabab, make sure about the idea. How to solve this? How to solve? You will write this as x plus square root of x minus 4 plus x cubed equals to 0, and you will call it f of x. Now you will go to the first choice. You will find out what is f of 0. This is the end of the class. And then f of 1. What is f at 0, Shabab? It is negative 4. Okay? What is f at 1? F at 1, it is 2, negative 4, it is 1. It is negative 1, am I right? So both of them are negative, so we cannot use them to find the root. I'll try another one, f at 2. So here I have f of 1, f of 2, so it is not. This is not the answer. F, what is the value of the function at 2? It will be 2 plus square root of 2 minus 4 plus 8. It will be positive. So this is greater than 0. This is negative, less than 0. This is less than 0. So I can take these two intervals. So from 1 to B, from 1 to 2. If you check the other choices, they will be positive, either positive both or negative both. But only 1 and 2, they will be one of them positive, one of them is negative. We are done with section 2.5, Shabab. Unfortunately, we are behind. We are supposed to finish 2.6 this week, but we will try to catch up later, inshallah. Thank you, Shabab, and see you next Sunday. Have a nice, hard-working weekend, because you need to prepare for quiz number 1 and quiz number 2.
Doctor, assalamu alaikum.
Yes.
Doctor, yes. Doctor, I'm in the section اللي فات من الساعة 9 إلى 9:30. حصل مشكلة. اي حصل مشكلة بالانترنت وحبيت بس اخبرك اني حضرت
على الواتساب. طبعا you are not allowed to do that, لكن it's okay if you have a problem we will check. عشان اسجلك الحين في الغياب والحضور واسجل ملاحظة عليك انك حضرت مع سيكشن اخر, لانه you are not allowed to do that always.
I'm sorry but there was a problem with the internet.
No problem, it's okay.
Thank you so much.
بالتوفيق.
يعطيك
العافية
دكتور.
يعافيكم بالتوفيق يا شباب. See you ان شاء الله next Sunday.
Thank you دكتور.
Have a nice weekend دكتور.
For you also ان شاء الله. I'll stop recording and